Tell us about the two sides of your character, what the world actually sees versus who President Business, Lord Business really is.
Yeah, what the world actually sees is kind of this benevolent leader who's kind of has his hand. He's very unique in that he literally runs every aspect of the Lego world, and he's involved from a corporate level. He produces television shows, entertainment. He does every single facet. And seems like a pretty good guy, and that he has, you know, all the Lego people's interest, you know, best interest at heart. But underneath it all, he's really about control, and he's not a fan of any sort of creativity, and any sort of thinking, individuality that would be outside of what he controls.
Now, any theory as to why he has this sort of evil dark side?
I think, you know, probably it all stems from not feeling loved or liked. Maybe he had a bad childhood. We don't know. Maybe that will be in the prequel.
There are a lot of great laughs in this film. How would you describe the humor overall?
You know, I think the movie is really inventive. I don't think there's kind of anything like it. You really don't know what to expect in terms of coming to see it. But you know, I would say the movie is in terms of humor is. It's great for kids. It's silly and has a lot of visual things that kids love. At the same time, it's really kind of fun and subversive for the adults, and you know, comments on not only, you know, creative expression and big broad topics like that, but also just the way we kind of live nowadays and pokes fun at things like that. So it's, while it's simple and silly, it's very sophisticated too, somehow, at the same time.
What do you think, being with all the humor, what do you think is the funniest thing about your character? Like, he's got a lot of humor in him with the dark side, but what is the funniest part of him?
I love that he's kind of at least present business, that he's kind of manic, that he's controlling all these things, and yet it's too much. It's almost too much for him, for one person to do. And then in terms of Lord Business, I just love his almost 20-foot tall Elton John-like boots.
I was going to ask you about the boots. What is it about the boots that...
I don't know. I think in his mind, boots, it just equates power. And it's a bad choice.
Now, did working on this movie bring back any memories for you? Did you play with Legos as a child?
Oh, yeah. I mean... I don't know. I mean, I think you'd be hard pressed to find anyone in my age group who didn't play with Legos. It was such a fun toy to play with, because they were just, you know, it's a bag of blocks, but there's something pleasing about them texturally and the way they're set up that you can literally make anything that your imagination, you know, wants to do. And you know, that was a big part of growing up, and also too, I it's so interesting that it's around the world. I think everyone knows what a Lego is, and I don't know. There are a few toys that are like that, in a way.
They go from generation to generation.
Yeah.
What are some of the, in your opinion, what is the main theme of this film?
You know, there's one of the themes definitely is always be creative, you know, don't afraid to dream and things like that. But I think the main theme is that there's no such thing as being ordinary. That we're all extraordinary in our own way, and that you may feel like you don't have an impact on anyone or anything in the world, but even like the smallest act of kindness or the smallest kind of gesture on your part to help the world is impactful, and to never forget that.